It's going to be such a great daytime today. We have food coming up. We have whiskey coming up. We just talked about a book, and now we have entertainment. But first, to find out a little bit more about it, Barry Finley, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Trevor Finley.
Hi.
Any relation?
We've known each other for a while.
Yeah. It's good to have you back in town, by the way. I know that Nashville keeps you busy these days.
It does, yeah.
But you came home to do a favor for Dad?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I mean, it's a great cause. I'm going to let you do most of the talking about that, but yeah. It's a great cause, and I'm happy to lend whatever I can do
great.
To do it.
So, Barry, what is the cause?
The cause is, it's called Education for Africa, mm-hmm. but this specific one is a sanitation project that we've been working on for a couple of years. Mm-hmm. It's going to provide clean water and sanitation for kids in a rural community in Tanzania, Africa. So,
now, we were talking about this outside in the green room, is that we've both done Mount Kilimanjaro. Is that what inspired you?
Yeah, I did Mount Kilimanjaro in 2009, mm-hmm. and before we went, we decided to raise some money. We wanted to do it for kids, so we raised some money to drill a well in Tanzania. That worked out well, and then we ended up helping out with a classroom. We helped some young women start small businesses, and now we're on the sanitation project. So I climbed the mountain, and then it kept going from there.
Well, it is an inspirational place. So where is the village that you focus your efforts?
It's a place called Mwanza. Tanzania, it's on Lake Victoria, so it's about an hour's flight from Dar es Salaam.
Mm-hmm. So you're doing it at Greenfields. Tell us about the actual event other than your star son appearing.
Yeah, Trevor is headlining. We've also got Chad Wolf and his fiddlers and step dancers from his studio of dance and music. Mm-hmm. And we've got the Teen Rufero Marimba Band that are going to be playing the music of Africa. And Terry Loretto is our guest MC from CBC.
So very well known CBC broadcaster. So when is it?
It's Sunday, October 15th. Starts at 1:30.
Starts at 1:30. So an afternoon shindig.
Yes. Yeah. We've been doing that now for this is our seventh.
Have you been back to the village to see the work that you are inspiring?
We went back in 2011, mm-hmm. and we're going back again in January.
Are you going to climb the mountain again?
No.
You want to think about that for a second?
I think that was a one-off.
Yeah, we have very similar views on that. It was much harder than people think. You're not just walking up a hill.
It's tough.
And the weather, how was your weather when you did it?
The weather was good.
Okay.
I have no complaints.
We had.
And no excuses because of the weather.
We had rough weather. It was, snow in the tent kind of weather.
What's the percentage of people that actually make the summit, though? You said it was like,
it's a low percentage.
Yeah.
I'm very grateful I got there.
It's amazing. I'm amazed.
But the last 8 hours, right? The last eight hours are pretty tricky.
It's a killer.
What was it that inspired you to keep working there in Tanzania?
It was meeting the kids. Talk about his own answer, but it was meeting the kids. We took a Canadian flag with the names of our donors on it and presented it to a classroom of kids. And meeting them, I just thought we can help them. You know, we can continue doing things to help them out. So
We're going to listen to Trevor, but you have a reason as to why he was still so inspired?
Well, one of my favorite things to say is that he climbed the mountain, chartered accountant, and came back down a philanthropist. So,
Yeah. Well, you know what? Being a chartered accountant is good in philanthropy, too, though,
it
isn't
is. It?
It
helps, yes.
Got to keep track of those charitable dollars. And can people just drop by? Can they just come and see?
Yeah, there are a few reserved seats left.
Okay.
But there will be tickets at the door as well, so.
Okay, great. Now we're going to hear from your talented son.
All right.
There's a bad smoke hanging around Missoula. Got no one left to drink with in Great Falls. Got debts to pay in Coeur d'Alene and all around the Flathead. There's checks I've written bouncing off the walls. Well, I hear those bells of Helena chiming like the sound of breaking glass in my head. My body's aching and I'm paying for my sins, but that's alright. That just means I made it through the night. If you could be a tall tree in a strong wind, If you could be an old horse in the rain, if you could be a roadside shopper with bullet holes, you know what it feels like in my brain. Well, I hear those bells of heaven chiming, like the sound of breaking glass in my head. My body's aching and I'm paying for my sins, but that's alright. That just means I made it through the night. Oh, that's right. Deep in mostly empty bottles, the world looks so much harder through bloodshot eyes. I hope I had a good time, but if I know me well, I rock the boat until it capsized. Well, I hear those bells of heaven chiming, like the sound of breaking glass in my head. My body's aching and I'm paying for my sins, but that's alright. That just means I made it through the night. Through the night. Ah, that's good for everybody.